Okay, students, so we were talking about the first question. The two satellites of identical masses orbit the Earth at different heights. Okay, orbit the Earth at different heights. So we'll draw the question. Two satellites are there. At different heights they are orbiting. Okay, at different heights. This is first satellite and this is, let us take, second satellite. Okay, they are orbiting at different heights. And what they have given? The ratio of the centers of their two. Let us call this as R1 and this as R2. Okay, the ratio of this distance is given as, in question they have given is D is to 1. That means R1 upon R2, what is it? D is to 1 they have given. Okay, similarly at this height, at a certain height, will the gravitational acceleration be same as that of the Earth? On the Earth, surface of the Earth, it is G. It is equals to 9.8. But at the height, it will not be. At the height, it will be GH, given by the two formulas that you know. Yes? Okay, what are the formula? GH equals to what? GH equals, yes, we have two formula for height. First one is G, yes, R upon R plus H the whole squared. Where what is G? G at the surface of the Earth. Height is the height from the surface of the Earth. And what is the second formula for that? G is equals to 1 minus 2H by R. So satellites are generally kept at very higher heights. So we mostly use for satellites, we use this formula. Okay? Yes. Now we are talking about the heights. So what is the, what about the height at this point? Acceleration due to gravity, they have given that GH, and for GH for second body and GH for first body. So you can see in the textbook what is given. The ratio of the heights is given as G is to 1. So what is the ratio of GH1 upon for the first satellite and G at the height of second satellite is what? G upon 1. Yes. So this is what they have given in the question. Now what is to be found out? Okay, this is all given in the first question. What is to be found out in this question? What is to be found out is the value of critical velocity. Find the ratio of their orbital velocities. What is orbital velocity? V orbital. Any or the orbital velocity of a satellite is given by under root gr. Yes, students, learn this formula. What is that? Under root gr. Where what is g? Let us put it small r because we are talking about the length between the satellite and the planet. So this orbital velocity has the value of small g into r, where what is g? G is the value of acceleration due to gravity at that height, at that height, not on the surface of the Earth. Okay, so v orbital will be different. If the value of g changes, value of orbital velocity also will change. And how does this change with height? Okay, so a satellite with higher height will have different value of g. Okay, and this is the radius. What is the r? R is the distance between the two planets. Okay, remember the value of orbital velocity. What is the value of orbital velocity? Always small g into r. Where what is small g? Small g is the acceleration due to gravity at that height. Okay, that, like at this height it is g is to 1 that they have given. So we will use the comparison method and find the answer. Okay, so what is the orbital velocity formula? VO1 upon VO2. Ratio of orbital velocities is given by this formula. Yes, what is that? G1 R1 upon under root G2 R2, because different at different heights we have different gravitational accelerations. So what do we have this? G1 upon G2, what is it? G1 upon G2 is G by 1. Very good, G by 1. And what is R1 upon R2? It is D by 1. So what is the ratio of orbital velocities? Ratio of orbital velocities V01 upon V02 will be equals to under root GD by 1. So this is your final answer. Okay, simple, nothing but same formula. Yes, is it simple? Okay, good. We have understood this question. Always remember that this is critical orbital velocity. In some textbooks, critical orbital velocity word also used is critical velocity. Orbital velocity and critical velocity is the same velocity. How did we derive this? We had derived it last time equating to centripetal force. Yes? Yes. So we have derived this last time. Okay, so we are directly going to use this formula. Getting students? Okay, now we'll go for the next question. What is the next question? Newton's inverse square law is deduced from Kepler's dash law of planetary motion. Yes, which law of planetary motion? Yes, Newton's second inverse square law. It was derived by which Kepler's law of motion? Yes, the third Kepler's law of motion. Yes, p square is directly proportional to r cube. You know this. Okay, so Newton's inverse square law was derived from this Kepler's law. Yes, okay. So now we'll go on for the next question. The acceleration due to gravity on the surface of a planet whose mass and diameter are double that of Earth is dash times the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the Earth. Next question is, the acceleration due to gravity of a surface of a planet whose mass and diameter are double that of Earth. There is a planet, okay, its mass and diameter are double that of Earth. Then they are asking what will be the acceleration due to gravity on that surface of the Earth. So is it simple? Yes. So you can imagine that and start solving. Okay. Yes. Question number 3. Mass is, okay, so let us take this as Earth and this as another planet. What is doubled is another planet P. What is given is that whose mass and diameter are double that of Earth. So mass is M, let us call mass of Earth is ME. What is the mass of the planet? Mass of the planet is 2ME. Okay, it is 2ME. What else is given? Diameter. If this diameter of the Earth, let us take diameter of the Earth is D, is what? D. Then what is the diameter of this planet? It is given that it will be 2D. It will be 2D. Okay, so they are asking the value of G on Earth and value of G on planet is what? Okay. So will be dash times, means what? GP will be how many times that of G Earth? This is the question. You have to fill in the blank. Simple formula. What we can take is, take the comparison method, take the ratios. Gravity on the planet P is given by GM upon R square. Yes, and gravity on the mass of planet and radius of planet. And what will be the gravity of the Earth? G into mass of the Earth upon radius of the Earth squared. Okay? Yes. Now, see, because we have used comparison method, we can directly cancel this G upon G. And what is mass of the planet is? 2 times the mass of Earth. Okay, what is the radius of planet? Now, you know that diameter of planet upon diameter of Earth will be what? 2 times radius of planet upon 2 times radius of Earth. Yes or no, students? Okay, because diameter is always 2 times radius. So diameter ratio, what is the diameter ratio? DP upon DE. What is DP? This is diameter of planet. Diameter of planet is 2 times diameter of Earth. Let us call this diameter of Earth. Okay, so what is diameter of Earth? 2 times diameter of Earth. Okay, upon DE. 2 gets cancelled with 2. So radius of planet upon radius of Earth is how much? 2:1. So radius of planet upon radius of Earth is 2:1. This is what we have found out. Yes, a planet whose diameter is doubled, its radius will also be doubled. Yes? Yes, because see, if this diameter is only doubled, then radius will also be doubled. Yes or no? Like that. Okay. So we have RP is equals to what? RP, let us write this properly. First of all, we'll write this properly. MP upon RP squared upon ME upon RE squared. So what is MP upon ME? MP upon ME is given by 2. See here, MP upon ME, just rearrange it, that will be what is the mass of planet upon mass of Earth into radius of Earth upon radius of planet the whole square. Okay, we can solve this further now. What is the mass of planet? Mass of the planet is 2 times the mass of Earth and ME. What about the radius of planet? Yes, radius of planet is 2 times, let us solve this, RP is 2RE. Okay, we are just rearranging the formulas so that we can cancel out maximum terms. So you have to look how to cancel the terms, how to take what is in what times of the others, and just reduce the formula and get the answer. 2RE. RE cancels with RE, ME cancels with ME. 2, it's remaining same. Wait, we have to do squared here. Yes, students, yes. So 2 upon 4, that is 1 by 2. So GP upon GE is what? GP upon GE is equals to 1 by 2. What is the question? Yes. Acceleration due to gravity on the surface will be how many times? It will be half times. Yes, it will be how many times? So acceleration due to gravity on the planet is half times the acceleration due to gravity on Earth. See, the mass is bigger. The diameter is also bigger, but the radius is, acceleration due to gravity is small. Why? Because when its volume increases, the distance from the center is also increasing. That is increasing how much? That is increasing square times. If mass is increasing two times, okay, but what about radius? That is increasing in square times, right? So it is moving away from the center, so its acceleration is due to force will also be less, na, on that body. So it will be less. Always remember, it is inverse square law. Okay, students? Yes, so isn't it interesting? Very good. Nice. Let's move on. Okay, next question. Every planet revolves around the sun in an elliptical orbit with sun located at one of its foci. Orbital velocity is independent of orbiting mass of orbiting body. See, we know the formula of acceleration, orbital velocity. What is that? Vc or Vo, orbital velocity equals what? Vc, or we can call it Vo, is equals to how much? G into R. Yes? Of an orbiting satellite, with what velocity it should rotate? What is its velocity? V should be equals to under root gr, where what is this r? R is the distance from that of that satellite. With this velocity the satellite will rotate, then only it will complete circle. If it is more, it will fly off. If it is less, then it will fall down on earth. It should be equal to this value. And what is this value? This value is the value of g at a height and radius at distance of that satellite from the earth at that height. So this is that formula. In this formula, do you see there is mass anytime? There is nowhere mass. So it is independent of mass. If the satellite is bigger, then also at this height it will move with same velocity. If the mass is very small, then also it should move with same velocity. If you take a ball at a certain height and if you want to keep that ball rotating around the earth, it should rotate with same velocity VO. Okay. And if instead of that ball you have a big satellite, and that also you have going to move around the earth, so they both should move in same velocity. There is not that because of satellite is mass is having more, it should move with more velocity, it should require more velocity. Not like that. Okay, it is independent of mass. We have cancelled it when we have equated to centripetal force. Okay, do you remember that? We had solved it, mv square by r, there is a centripetal force formula. Yes. Okay. So remember this formula, VO equals under root gr. We have do not have mass, so it is independent of mass. Let's move on next. Yes. The mass of the body can never be. What is the question 7? The mass of the body can never be. Yes. Do you have its answer? The mass of the body can never be different, right? The mass of the body can never be different. Yes. 1 kg force equals to how many times? Yes, 1 kg force. Now, what is 1 kg force? 1 kg force is the weight of the 1 kg mass of the body. What is 1 kg force? 1 kg force is the weight of the mass of 1 kg. 1 kg force is equals to weight of 1 kg body. So, 1 kg into force means you have to multiply that with acceleration, because this is already the unit of mass. So what is it? 1 kg. What is the question? They have asked in dynes. In dynes they have asked. So what is the value of g? G is 10 meters per second squared. Yes. To be precise, we will call it in, they have asked in dynes, right? So we will call it 1 kg equals to how many grams? 1000 grams. And 10 meters squared is equals to how many? Let us use the accurate word. 10, and how many meters per second square? That is 100 centimeters per second square. This comes out to be how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's at the end of the bath, 6 dynes. Okay. What is this actually? Grams. Grams into centimeters per second square. So this is actually nothing but dynes. 10 to the bar 6 dynes. Okay, students, 10 to the bar 6 dynes. This is mass that you know, okay, 1 kg force. Yes. So whenever we are using any mass of the body, we are using like if you say that my mass is 60 kg, okay, so we have to multiply it by 10 to get in newtons. Okay, so actually we are talking about kgf. Whenever somebody asks us what is your weight, so you take 50, that's a 50 kgf. Okay, good. 50 kgf. Okay. So we use commercial term, we use KGF. We always say, so actually, but we measure in terms of weight, right? Actually, it is not kg, but indirectly it is KGF. But we practically commercially don't use this word F. We directly say weight is 1 kg, but actually it means 1 KGF. Getting students, isn't it right? Okay. Yes. Huh. Mass of the body can never be. Mass of the body can never be means this question is like you would not find what is its answer. Oh, mass can never be means what? While in lesson this we know weight is changing, but what will not change? Mass will not change. So directly, if you somebody asks its answer, mass of the body can never be different. Okay. Think little different for this answer. Okay. Next, value of g is dash at poles. At poles, what happens? Value of gravity. Value of gravity at poles. Yes, value of gravity at poles will be what? Value of gravity will be at poles will be maximum. Why? Two reasons. First of all, Earth is little flattened, so radius at the this is exactly spherical, but at the poles at all these countries, yeah, the Earth is little bulged. Okay, it is bulged, right? It is in this shape. Little, not too much. Okay, not too much. So here what happens, value of R is less. And one more thing that I have brought this globe for is, while it rotates, what happens? While the Earth rotates, what happens? If there is an object placed here and there is an object placed here, so if I rotate this, which will try to fly off from the Earth surface? This body, which is on the equator, it will try to fly off because Earth is rotating. And if you place anything here or at the bottom, let us consider, then this will not experience the centrifugal force. Centrifugal force means anything that rotates, it moves away from the center. So all the bodies on the equator, when they rotate, when the Earth rotates, it tries to fly off. So what happens? It reduces the gravitational acceleration which is going inside the Earth. So it opposes that. The centrifugal force opposes the gravitational force at the points of equator, because it is rotating more. Because Earth, if you take, it is going to be like this, right? It is going to rotate like this. And if you take the bodies on equator, they are rotating this much big, with this much big speed. While what about poles? They are rotating only this much. Okay, so this will fly off more and this will fly off less. So this will oppose more. So gravitation acceleration will reduce here because opposition is more, and gravitational acceleration will not reduce here because only little opposition is there. Yes? So they will, the gravitation at poles is more. So gravitation at poles is more, students. Yes, simple. Gravitation at poles will be more. Okay? Getting? Very good. Now let's move on to the next question. What is that? Okay. Yes. When a body is at a depth d from the Earth's surface, its distance from the center of the Earth is, what will that? Capital R minus d. Why? Because from the center of the Earth it will be R minus d. Okay. If you go on deep in, up till d, so what will be this distance from the center of the Earth? It will be R minus d. Okay, this imaginary sphere, that will be the pulling actual part of the Earth that is pulling us. Good. Next, what is the next question? The atmosphere of the body is held to the Earth by, yes, due to the Earth's gravitational force. Okay, Earth's gravitational force. Otherwise, what would happen? The gases would have escaped out. The gases would have escaped out. Yes. The escape velocity of the Earth is more than the actual velocity of the gas. Even gas keep on moving, but that velocity is not so much as the escape velocity of the Earth. If it would be more than escape velocity, then Earth would not have any atmosphere. Okay, like Moon doesn't have any atmosphere because the particles, any gas that would have accumulated on the Moon, its velocity is more than the actual velocity of the escape velocity of the Moon at that point. Okay, that is to be remembered. So that is not asked. What is asked is due to gravitational force. Next, if F is the force between two bodies of mass m1 and m2 at certain separation, then force between root 2 m1 and root 2 m2 at the same separation is. So what they have asked is, now instead they have changed the mass of the body. They have changed the mass of the body. Let us go for the question number 12. Question number 12. What is that question? Okay, if the force between two bodies of mass m1 and m2 are at certain separation, then the force between root 2 m1. Okay, m1, first body is m1. okay, and next board is M2, okay, then they have certain separation, let us call it D, let us call that separation D, then force between, next case is force between root 2 M and this is root 3 M2, this is root 2 M1 and this is root 3 M2, okay, then line of separation is D only. Here they are telling that the force is F, then what will be, how many times of F they are asking, or they are asking what will be the force here. So simple method, yes, what do you have asked in terms of comparison method, yes, what is that? F is equals to what? F equals G M1 M2 upon D square. Here what will be it? F is equals to G, F, let us call it F dash, will be equals to what? M1 dash upon M2 dash upon D dash square. Now what is that? F dash equals to what? G is constant. M dash, M1 dash is what? M1 dash is how much? Root 2 of M1. So we have root 2 of M1. What is M2 dash? M2 dash is root 3 of M2. Is root 3 of M2 upon D dash. What is D dash? D dash is equals to D. D dash is equals to D only, because they have said distance of separation is same. Now what will happens? Now we can use compare 1 upon 2, comparing both the situations. So what do we have here? F dash, let us call it, we want to find the value of F dash, right? So let us put 2 upon 1, okay, let us divide equation 2 divided by 1, okay, so F dash upon F, because we want this value, right? So that should be equals to what? G root 2 M 1 root 3 M2 upon D squared upon G M1 M2 upon D squared. Yes, GG gets cancelled, D squared get cancelled. Okay, M1 M1 get cancelled, M2 M2, and what is the answer? F dash is equals to root 2 into root 3, that is root 6. F here is multiplying, here it will multiply. So what is the answer? Is root 6 times the force, will be equals to root 6 times the force. Okay, you write this down. Root 6 times the force. Okay, this is the new force of the new body. Okay, students, getting simple? Okay, let's take the next question. What is the next question, students? Yes, 13th question. Let us move on a little faster. The direction of force along the line joining, the direction of force is always along which line? How that the forces will be acting? Forces always act not in this way or this way, they always act along the line joining the centers of the two bodies, not along the surface to this surface. It always acts along the line joining centers of the two bodies. How does the force act? Force act along which part? Force acts along the line joining the centers of the two bodies. Yes. Force always acts along this line. This body will move only in this direction. This body will always move in this direction. This will be the line of action. Line of action along the centers of two bodies. Line of action is along the line, is along the line joining centers of two bodies. Good. Okay, yes, which was this question? This question was question number 13. Okay, next one is a place where value of g is unaffected by increase or decrease in speed of the rotation about its own axis is. Okay, this is very interesting question. 14th question. The place on the earth where, if earth suddenly starts to rotate fast, if earth suddenly starts to rotate fast, so what would happen? We, let us take that in 1 hour only 1 day is happening. Okay, so we'll see at now 11 o'clock. Now it is, let us take 9:30 sunrise, 10:30 sunset, 9:30 sunrise, 10:30 sunset. It's so fast. Then what would happen on the people living on the equator? So vigorously the earth is rotating, the centrifugal force, we will fly off in space, we will just go up in sky. Okay, if earth is rotating so fast, we are sitting on the earth, we will try to be fly down, we will go in space. So our weight will what? our downward weight will reduce, right? But what happens on the poles? On the poles, they are not rotating, they are only making shorter circles at the poles, if you see. Okay, as we rotate here, what happens? See, these are not rotating so fast, but these people are rotating fast. Here the people are not rotating so fast. Is it that they are rotating? If I rotate the earth very fast, they are not rotating so fast. They are rotating very tiny. So they will not fly off in the space. We are this at the equator will fly off. So value of G will be unaffected here. Value of G will be affected here because of the centrifugal force. Value of G will be affected here only. So value of G will not get affected on the poles. Good. By the increase or decreasing the speed only, huh? Okay. Good. Next question. Universal gravitational constant is independent of intervening media. Means what? Between Earth and Moon, if you have filled up space with some huge strong material that to oppose gravitational force will not get affected. It is independent of any medium that is there in between. Okay? It is independent of any medium. You put anything, it will be same amount of force. Yes? See now, your weight now on this building is, let us take my weight is 60 kgf. Here, if I instead of at the same height, if I put certain thing in below my this building, I put very strong material to block that gravitational force, my weight will not get changed, it will be 60 kgf only. This is how it happens. It is independent of intervening medium. True or false? Let us play it fast. Okay, first 16. Any two bodies in the universe attract each other, true or false? Yes, true. The weight of the body on the surface of the moon is 1/6 that of Earth's surface, correct? It is because acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the moon is 6 times. No, it is 1/6 times. That is why gravity is, weight is 1/6 because of gravity, not because of the gravity as moon is 6 times more. Let us write it. Two is weight on moon upon weight on Earth equals to mg on moon upon mg on Earth. M mass is independent. What is that? G on moon is how much? 1/6 of Earth. 1/6 of Earth. That is why weight of moon is 1/6 that of weight of Earth. Okay, not because of it is 6 times, but it is because it is 1/6 times. Good. Okay, let's move on next. Acceleration due to gravity becomes half at the depth, half of the radius. Is it true? At the depth we have which formula? At the depth we have which formula? G depth. Right, G depth is equals to G upon 1 minus D by R. At the depth equals to half of the Earth's radius. So you have dug of the R by 2, you have dug deep into the Earth. Okay, so what is the new radius? The new radius is R minus R by 2. Okay, so let us, yes, that is the new depth. But directly we have the formula in terms of depth. So directly use it. What depth that we have to use? Gd equals to G 1 minus D is R by 2, yes, upon R. So they have, what is this happening? G 1 minus RR get cancelled, 1 minus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. So G by 2. So G at that depth will be how much? It will be half times. If you dig half of the Earth's radius deep, if you go out deep at half of the Earth's radius, then your gravity at that point will be half of the gravity that is there here. So your weight will be how much? Half. Your weight will be half. If you go 3200 kilometers deep, your weight will be only half of your weight. But about high, it reduces very fastly because we have minus 2h at height formula difference. Yes? Yes, students, is it that? Okay. Now let's move on to the next. Yes. Mass of the body is constant everywhere in the universe. True. As the distance of the planet from Sun increases, period of revolution decreases. We have third Kepler's law for this. Third Kepler's law. Period of a planet around the Sun is equals to what? Time period is given by T squared is directly proportional to R cube. If you move away, what is R? R is the semi-major axis. R is the distance of, this is Sun. This is Sun. This is Earth. Earth's semi-major axis from the elliptical orbit. This is Mars. Venus, Jupiter. So each and every R1 for Earth is different, R2 for Mars is different, okay, R3 for that another planet is different. So if radius increases, semi major time period of that revolution also increases. Yes, this is about Kepler's third law. Okay, students, Kepler's third law. Which question we are talking about? 20th. If a radius increases, time period also increases. Simple question. Yes, so what will be the answer? Distance of planet increases, period of revolution decreases? No, it should also increase. Yes. See, the planets which are farther away from the sun, they have so many years they to take to complete one revolution around the sun, isn't it? Yes. Gravitation force can be repulsive? False. The gravitation force is always attractive. Question number 21 remaining. As planet moves around the sun, it sweeps equal areas in equal interval of time. Kepler's second law. Yes, the orbital velocity is nearly 0.70 times the escape velocity. Use the two formulas. Use the two formulas and get the answer. The orbital velocity, question number 23. Orbital velocity is under root gr. Let us write the formula first. And escape velocity is under root 2gr. Now we want to compare. Sometimes we take this small r, because if we are taking at certain height, then when we have put here capital R, it means that we have kept it on the Earth surface. Okay. R. If you move at certain height h, then use what? R plus h, then it becomes smaller. Because we have defined capital R as Earth's radius, that is 6400 kilometers. Okay. Now we are comparing. So V0. We are comparing in terms of orbital velocity. So VE upon V0 is what? 2GR upon under root GR. So what is happening? VE is GR gets cancelled with GR. Yes. So under root 2 upon 1, that is root 2 the orbital velocity. So what is orbital velocity? Orbital velocity is 1.414 times. Escape velocity is 1.414 times. If you ask what is orbital velocity, so V orbital velocity will be what? From here, what do we get? One more term. If you rearrange this, root 2, we will be dividing here. So VO equals what? 1 upon root 2 VE. Yes? What is 1 upon root 2? 1 upon root 2 is 0.707 times escape velocity. So these two you remember also. These two you remember also. Okay, box this in your notebook. These two formula, you box this. And students have, while you are writing this, after you finish writing, you will send me the photographs of your notebook. Next. If heavenly objects like asteroid or planetoid revolving around the sun moves into orbit of smaller radius, then its speed increases. Yes, we are talking about the Earth. Suddenly what happens? If the radius of that revolving planet is reduced, then what would happen? You have to pause the video and write whatever you are trying. Sun, planet, Earth, let us take, and this is Mars. If Mars comes into Earth's orbit, what would happen? We know Kepler's third law. T squared is directly proportional to R cube. If radius is becoming less, if Mars jumps into Earth's orbit, if its radius will decrease, then from Kepler's law, what will happen? Its time period will also decrease, right? So it will, Mars was moving very, very slow, but when it comes in Earth's orbit, it will move in less time. Time is less, na? Time is less. So time is less means it is moving fast. That means speed is increased. That is what we have learned. So if it jumps in planet of smaller radius, its speed should increase. Very good. Maximum heights reached by the bodies that are vertically projected with same velocity on the surface of the moon are same. What are they are talking about? Heights. If you throw an object on the Earth, okay, and if you throw another object on moon, if you throw both the objects on Earth and on moon, then if the object reaches height h on Earth, then will it reach, if I throw with same velocity on moon, will it reach at the same height? No, it will not reach. If I throw with this velocity, it has reached certain height. Will it reach at the same height on moon? No, on moon gravity is less. 1/6. So it will, on moon it will try to get, it will, it is not pulled downwards. So it, on moon it will fly more height, it will go to a more height. Let us see how do we find this with equations. Okay, how to find that? You know that kinematic equation, because we have to find height. Height is what? S is equals to ut plus half at squared. Which method you want to use? Kinematics, gravitation or motion equation? Let's go for the old method. S is height, ut plus half, acceleration is minus g, t squared. Okay, yes, but we are asking in terms of velocity, so we'll use the next equation. V square is equals to u square plus 2as. Okay, should we use this or should we use the next? We can find with anyone. You have given the initial velocity. Final velocity will be anything, you always know it will be zero. When you throw anything upwards, it will be always zero. So we have on Earth and on Moon, let us write. So final velocity will be zero. So for Earth, what will be happening? Zero equals to initial velocity of the object given on the Earth squared plus 2, acceleration due to gravity is minus g on Earth. What is that? Height taken on Earth. What is this height telling us? Height is equals to what? U squared. Here it will become minus upon minus 2g. Minus minus getting cancelled. So what will be the value of height? That will be u square upon 2ge. Ue is what? It is the velocity with which it is thrown on Earth. Similarly, if you resolve this equation for Moon, same equation for Moon will be u 0 squared is equals to u on Moon squared plus 2 minus g of on Moon into height achieved on Moon. So if you find the value of height on Moon, this is height on Earth. So what is the height on Moon? This is minus um here, this is minus 2g of Moon, height m, minus minus gets cancelled. Now we want to compare height on Earth and height on Moon. What can we do is ue, they have given that on Earth and on Moon that both the objects are thrown with same velocity. Ue is equals to um. Now we want to find how much high this rises and how much high this rises. This is he and this is hm. We want to find the value of height received on Moon, so we'll use the comparison method. That hm upon he. What is hm? Um squared upon 2gm. What is he? Ue squared upon 2ge. Um is equals to ue, so it can get cancelled. Yes? Okay, so we'll write this. Um squared upon ue squared, denominator is numerator. Same values get cancelled, 2 gets cancelled. So we have hm upon he. We want to find about height, comparison of height. So what is g moon? G moon is 1/6 of g earth, isn't it? Instead of gm I have written 1/6 of earth. So what is this hm upon he? Are you getting it? This is upon 6 equal to. Okay. Now denominator goes in numerator, g should get cancelled. So this is how much? Now you write is hm upon he, denominator goes to numerator, equals to 6 times of 1. So on Moon it will go 6 times higher if you take it on the other side. Let us take it on the other side. Finally what do we have? Hm is equals to 6 times he. So on Moon you throw an object, it moves 6 times higher than when it is placed on Earth. Simple. On Moon it goes 6 times higher than when it is thrown on Earth. Any object that is thrown on Moon will move 6 times higher. Simple. Okay, next, match the following. G at at a height is given by, height formula is g to 1 minus 2h by r. G at the depth is g to 1 minus d by r. G at the equator is on equator it will be minimum because centrifugal forces are trying to pull it away. On the equator it will be, value of gravity will be minimum, your weight will be minimum on equator because you will be always thrown outside due to centrifugal force. Yes? Okay. And last one, on the poles it will be maximum. Yes? Yes, two reasons, due to the flatness and due to the centrifugal forces. Next slide, the following: orbital velocity is under root gr, escape velocity is under root 2 gr. We have learned this. Capital G is 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 newton meter square per kg square. Small g on the earth is 9.8 meters per second square. G on moon is 1/6 divided by 6, 9.8, it will be 1.67. We have learned this last year in lesson stars. Okay, next question. If r is the radius of the earth, height at which the weight of the body becomes 1/4, 1/4 its weight on the surface of the earth is. Okay, so we are talking about height. Okay, so solving this, height on a at a height the weight is how much? 1/4. Use this so that you can cover up the maximum board. The height at which the weight of the body becomes 1/4 the weight of the earth. Height at which the weight of the body becomes 1/4 the weight on the surface of the earth. Simple? Then the height where it becomes. So what is that? We know VH upon V. What is VH? VH is mg at a height equals to 1/4. On the surface we have only mg formula. M is getting cancelled with m. Okay, so we have gh is equals to g into 1/4. And one more formula of GH we know. What is that? GH is equals to G into, what is that? For height we have two formulas. So better we will use this. Which one we will use? We can use both the formula. R upon R plus H whole square. Let us use that. So if you want to compare on this formula, so what can we get is 1/4 is equals to R upon R plus H whole square, because this is what the value of gravity is 1/4 at that height. At height the value of gravity is reduced, it is 1/4. So you know this formula, that at whatever height we know that formula. So if we compare, then we have 1/4 is equals to this value, then only its height is becoming 1/4, gravity is becoming 1/4 that of surface. So 1/4 should be equal to this term. Okay, then we will find the value of r. So square is square root here. 1 upon 2 is equal to r upon r plus h. Solve this, r cross multiply 2r, so h is equal to 2r minus r, that is r. So at height equal to radius, if this is earth, this is r, to take at the same height above the earth surface, h equals to r, your body's weight will be how much? Weight will be 1/4 on the earth's surface. Simple? Yes. So what is the answer? Question number B. Yes. Yes. What is that? Check the answer. So it is option B. Option B. Is it right? Yes. Now next question we'll take. Earth shrinks half in radius, the mass remaining same. The weight of the object on earth will change how much? Next question. Earth shrinks half in radius, the mass remaining same. Earth's mass is remaining same, but what happens is earth shrinks half of it. Hey, suddenly earth is this much. Okay, now suddenly it moves to half of its radius. Now this diameter is around this much. Okay, it is around this much. Okay, around this much. Suddenly what happens is that it becomes this much, part of the globe suddenly becomes this much, half. Then in that case, if the globe would be, earth would become like this. In that case, they are asking what will be the weight in that case. Suddenly it becomes half like this. So what will be weight in that case? So is it like earth's outside mass is going somewhere else? Then we would take the case of depth, but this is not the case of depth. Please be careful. This is not the case of depth. In depth, what happens? In depth, what happens? In depth, this part is not considered at all. This part is not considered. If a person is standing here, so this part and only the this part of the earth, which is below, that is R minus D, is considered as earth when you go deeper. But this is not the case of depth. What happens in the depth case of depth? Mass is also reduced. Mass is also reduced because radius is also earth. This is not real earth. This is a smaller part of the earth when you go deep. So the value of GD is differently calculated with that formula. GD is equals to G into 1 minus D by R. But this is different case. Earth is compressed. Compressed means what? Earth's mass is not going to change. Only Earth's radius is going to change. So mass is remaining constant. Mass is remaining constant. This is a case of compression. So what would happen in that case? Earth with this radius suddenly gets compressed to this, from this radius to half. That means it would get this much. And it is more dense now. It is more dense. Because it is compressed into same mass. In this case, what will be that? R nu is equals to half of R. Okay, R nu. Okay, compressed earth. Compressed earth has same mass. Okay, now in this case, we have to find the value of G. So small g equals g m by r squared on the earth surface. For any body, we'll apply new surface, new gravitational, new mass, new radius. Gravitation is never, capital G never becomes new or old. It is always constant. Okay, mass of the new planet is, let us compare with the earth. What is g? G here is g m upon r square. Now let us compare. Comparing because we want this. So we'll compare upon this upon this. G n upon g equals g m mass nu upon radius nu squared upon g mass upon radius squared. G gets cancelled with g. Nu mass remains same. The mass of the planet is not changed when it is compressed. So m n is equals to m. M n upon m r n squared. R squared. Mn and m are same, they get cancelled. Let us write it here. Okay, so can we have thank you. So please see this. Gn upon g equals to what? Equals r square upon what is new radius? New radius is half of the old radius. What is g nu is equals to g is equals to 1 by 2 square is 4, that is 1 by 4 upon, it will become 4. 4 r square upon r square is cancelled. So what is g nu? G nu is 4 times g. So what will be the weight? Mg nu is equals to 4 into mg, multiplying both sides by m. So weight will be, weight on the new compressed will be 4 times weight on surface. Just remember this. The case of two satellites. Okay, so what we can do is, we have two satellites. Okay, question number one, we have two satellites. One of them, okay, is placed at certain height and another of them is also placed at certain height, but what they have given is that the ratio of the distances from the center of the earth means what? From the center of the earth, if you call this as, and this is the next distance of the second satellite from the center of the earth. So if we call this R1 and if you call this R2, so what they have given is R1 upon R2 is what? They have given 1 upon D. This is the ratio that they have given. Very good, students. Now next part is what they have given? The ratio of acceleration due to gravity at those heights. Means whatever is the value of G, G at this height. Okay, this is the height. Yes, this is the height. So at this height, whatever is the value is given by, okay, they have given by 1 is to g. Okay, let us compare this. This is height, the value of acceleration g at g first height is equals to 1. Then at, let us say at for second height it is
G, because G1 upon G2, they have given 1 upon G. Is it that what they have given?
Yes, the ratio of their okay, so
Sequence matters. So what they have given in sequence, in question they have given D is to 1. So let us write D is to 1. So this becomes G is to 1. See? Okay, so what they have given, this ratio and this ratio, the ratio of R1 upon R2, they have given D upon 1. The ratio of G1, and that is acceleration due to gravity at this point, upon acceleration due to gravity at this point, is G is to 1. If this is G, then this is 1. They have given this in question. Dada, cut kare. Just remember this. Thank you, Dada. So please remember this is 4 times weight of the original. Simple? Yes. Next question is, they have asked what is the change? They have asked what is the change? So what is the change? Change is always final minus initial in percentage. So we'll solve it continuously. Now we'll solve. Weight is final minus initial. Weight is change in weight. What is change in weight? Change in weight is final weight minus original weight upon original weight. So what is the final weight? 4 times into, if you want to find in percentage, so let us multiply by 100. Final weight minus original weight upon original weight into 100. So what is the change? 3 into 100, that is 300%. It has increased by 300%. It has increased by 300%. Yes, students? Okay. The weight has increased by 300%. Is it that? Yes. So it has increased by 300%. Let's go on for the next. Yes, a body is weighing 72 newtons on the surface of the earth. What is the gravitational force on it due to the earth? At a height equal to half the radius of the earth from the surface. It is weighing how many? 72 newtons on earth surface. If you take it on a height equal to half of the radius of the earth, it is moved to a height which is half the radius of the earth. Then what will be that in that case? Height is half of the radius, considerable height. Use the first formula. Which one? Okay, if you have properly written in sequence, first write the part which was rubbed, then you write this, you write this. Okay. Okay, now see what happens. A body 72 newtons on the surface of the earth. What is the gravitational force on it at a height equal to radius of the earth from the surface? What is the height? Height is equal to radius of the earth. Just now we had found it out. It was how much at the height equal to radius of the earth? You remember? At the height equal to radius of the earth. Was it 1/4? I think we remember 1/4. Just few minutes before in question number. So, see, question number first MCQ, what the answer was? Second. So at a height equals to R, the value was 1/4. So by going through the same method, height will be, weight will be also 1/4, because gravity is also 1/4. So answer should be 72 by 4. That is how many? 18 newtons. Is in the answer. yes, it is not equal to radius, it is half of radius. So there is change in question. Question number 3, height is equals to half of radius. Okay, so put the formula, GH is equals to G into R upon R plus H whole squared. Okay, so what is the height? G is equals to R upon R plus H, that is R by 2 squared, that is GH. So just put the values, G into R plus 3 R by 2 whole squared. Okay, that is equals to G into 4 by 9. Okay, now we will multiply it by mass to both the sides. Multiplying by mass to both the sides, we have mgh equals to mg into 4 by 9, and this value is given, that is 72 newtons. So we have new weight is 8 4 is 32 newtons. Yes. Now next question, where will it be profitable to purchase the 1 kilogram of sugar? Where will it be profitable to purchase 1 kilogram of sugar? On poles, we are comparing from on poles to on Earth's equator. On poles and on Earth's equator. So we know the formula for weight is mgp, and we know formula for weight at Earth's equator is mge. So we know the value of gravity at poles is more. Value of gravity at poles is more, and value of gravity of the Earth is at the equator is less. So mass is same. So mass of the sugar will be same both the situations. But because of gravity of the on the poles is more, the weight will be record weight will be more for the same mass. So we will have to pay more on the poles. Okay, so we need to also pay more. Here we need to pay less. Okay, so it is more profitable to pay less. So on the equator, it is more profitable to purchase the 1 kilogram of sugar. Next, the figure shows planetary elliptical orbit around the sun. The kinetic energy of the planet will be maximum at when the planet is at. There are 4 positions given. So from that position, we will see which of the is fastest. So we have this 4 positions. Sun is there here. P1, P2, P3 and P4. So at which position it will be fastest? When it is at the closest. Okay. Why? Because as it moves here, it requires to cover more area, because radius vector is small, so it has to cover more length. More length it has to cover, then more its speed will increase. Here its speed should decrease. So at P1, the velocity speed will be more at P1. Okay. At P1, speed will be more. Why? Because Kepler's second law, FA equal areas. Okay, next. Mass of the body is m on the Earth surface, then mass of the same body on moon surface will be, yes, mass of the body is same anywhere, so it will be m. As we go from equator to the poles, the value of g increases. A body 700 newton on the surface of the Earth, what is its weight on the surface of planet whose mass is 1/7 and radius is half times? Mass is 1/7 and radius is half times. Okay, so we have that formula, g it equals to gm upon r square. Okay, for another planet, g dash equals to gm dash upon r dash squared. So we are want to find this new gravitational force. Okay, we want to find weight, so let us multiply by mass to both the sides. First let us compare, g dash upon g will be equals to m dash upon r dash squared upon m upon r squared. This equals m dash upon m r dash squared upon r squared. What is they have given? Mass is 1/7, so we have 1/7 of m upon m. What about radius? Radius is half times, so we have half r squared. So 1/7 upon 1 by 4, that is 4 by 7th of g dash upon g. So we have g dash is equals to 4 by 7th of g. Now we want to find weight, so we will multiply by mass to both the sides. We have mg dash is equals to 4 by 7 mg. What they have given? That initially weight was 700 newton. So we will write 4 upon 7 into 700. So we have 400 newton the new weight. Okay. Next, which of the following is true? G is same at all places on the surface of the earth? No. G has maximum value at equator? No, it is maximum at poles. G is less at the earth's surface than at a height above? No, at the surface it is maximum, and even at a height and at the depth is always less. So, G is greater at poles than equator. Yes, this is the last option is correct. 10th one. A simple pendulum has time period capital T. When on earth's surface it's capital T, 1, and when it is taken at height r, its value is T2. Then what will be the value of ratio of T2 upon T1, okay, when taken at a height r above earth's surface. So for pendulums we have one new formula, that is equals to time period equals to what? Time period equals to 2 pi under root L by G. What is this? If this is a pendulum, then this is the, it will oscillate, okay, then it will oscillate with length, whatever length of that pendulum is L, okay, and this, what is capital T? Capital T is the time period to come back to its original position from the entirely going to the opposite end and coming back to the same point. That is capital T time period. If you increase the length, then time period will also increase. If you increase the value of gravity is more, then it will, what happens, it is inversely proportional, means the downward force is more, then it will come fast. So value of gravity increases, time period will decrease because it will come fast, it will come in less time. So this formula we are going to use, what is that? Yes, T1 upon T2, when it is taken at certain height. This is the first case. On the earth surface, if the pendulum is kept, we have T is equals to 2 pi under root L upon G of earth surface. And if you take at a height above the earth surface, that is equals to H is equals to R. Okay, in that case, the pendulum is taken here, then we have T equals 2 pi under root L by G, where G is the new gravity at a height H equals to R. So we have this G dash. Okay, the length is same pendulum is taken on the next side. So what do we have here? T dash is the time period for this pendulum. Okay, this pendulum is going to oscillate, and at the surface it is this. So we'll compare T dash upon T. So we have 2 pi under root, same length, so we have L1 upon G dash on 2 pi under root L by G. Okay, 2 pi gets cancelled, length and length get also cancelled. We have under root of G upon G dash. So T dash upon T is equals to G upon G dash. Okay, we will write as T dash upon T is equals to under root of G upon G dash. Now, what is the value of G dash at a height equals to R? At the height equals to R, what is the value of G dash? It is equals to G dash equals to G into 1 at a height equals to R. So what is the value of height? It will be R. So just slightly directly, G dash will be equals to 1 upon 2. This is squared. That will be equals to 1 by 4th. Okay, let us write it. H equals to R. Now you put that H equals to R and solve directly, 1 by 2 whole squared 4. So we have G dash upon G is 1 by 4. This value we will put it here. G dash upon G is 1 by 4. So G upon G dash will be 4 upon 1. T dash upon T will be, so we have T dash is equals to under root of 4 is 2 times. So time period will be 2 times the time period on earth surface. Okay. That is option D. Okay. It is allowed.